Day 25, we're in the home stretch. Woo! Let's close our eyes, take deep breaths, see where we're going today. Big breath in and letting it go. Another big breath in and letting it go. Another big breath in and letting it go. Surrender is the word I keep hearing. Not sure if we've done that yet on this journey. My mind is foggy at the moment, but if we have, we're going to do it again. I don't feel we have. Surrender is powerful. Letting go. So let's come to our mats. Let's start on our back. Bring your knees in towards your chest and just start rocking back and forth, making circles with your knees. Let your knees come parallel position as your feet come to the earth, and just let your knees rock side to side here. Surrender. What is it you would like to surrender into? What is it you would like to let go of? This is such an important theme, for it implies that the initiation or the majority of the focus is no longer on the pushing or the forcing to make something happen, but it's really the opposite of going more in the flow. So as you're here breathing deeply, just let yourself go side to side, back and forth, releasing and letting go, surrendering. What is it you would like to surrender? Get really clear about that. Let's place your right foot on top of your left knee and just let yourself fall completely over to the right side. That right foot on the left knee here is pulling and moving that leg longer in its extension out of the left hip. Big breath in. Big breath out. Big breath in. Big breath out. Good. Coming back to center. And coming to the other side. Surrender. Letting go. If you root the head onto the mat and really let your spine become long, there's a wonderful lengthening and extension here. Let yourself become really, really long. Good. Big breath in. Big breath out. Another big breath in. Nice. Coming back to center. Keep that left foot on the earth and then interlace your fingers back behind your right extended leg. Flex through the toes. Send the ball of the foot up high towards the sky, a lot of extension through the heel. Really allow that leg to become long. You can make circles here with the feet and another direction. Let the breath be really long and full. In our upcoming days here, let's go the other side. Let yourself surrender into your theme, right? So we began this yoga journey connecting more into the intention to open up our channels to our intuition, but also with a very specific intention for yourself. If you can't remember, it's okay. It might have morphed, but if you can, just return back to that place where you began this journey. Today we add in the element of surrender, trusting that everything you've explored, everything you've been opening towards, is allowing you this greater expansion. It just is. It just is. Bring the soles of the feet together and just let yourself rock side to side here, opening up the groins area, letting the breath become really long and extended. Good. Two more breaths. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, big breath. And exhale. Awesome. Good. Oh, I feel it already. Let's grab our blocks. If you haven't noticed, I'm being guided to do a gentler exploration today. So, as always, you know, in our journey, if you want to pause and go back or redo, you'll be gravitated towards some days more than others.
Ah, surrender is such a good one.
It always feels so good because there's so much focus in our world to keep it going, keep pushing forward. Just make it work, make it work. It's nice when you just fall into that knowing that you are enough and you surrender and you sink into that in a real way. My guides are wanting to talk about a very specific thing right now with you. So what I've been seeing more and more in the sessions that I'm doing, especially in the area where I am right now, but really all over the world when I'm doing my sessions, one thing that I'm really seeing the need of here, so I'm getting a neck lengthener here and I'm getting the knees going side to side, I'm seeing the real need for a heavy metal detox. We have so many heavy metals in our system from a myriad of different places. And what is really important is to cleanse those from your body. One of my favorites ways of doing this, which is incredibly powerful, I've been doing it about 6 months and I can just really feel a difference. So if you ever had tinfoil, if you ever baked on a metal pan, if you have mercury fillings, or if you ever had mercury fillings, or if you live in the United States, or if you were born on planet Earth, you're going to have heavy metals in your system, varying different degrees. But well, the great news is that you can pull them out. You can pull them out. And what he prescribes are five things to do that. One, 2 cups of wild organic blueberries from Maine a day. If you can get in more, wonderful. Those are hard to get fresh. You can get them frozen. 1 cup of cilantro. Some barley grass juice powder. Vimex makes a great one. Hawaiian spirulina. Essential. I am so in love. It's one of my favorites. My guides show it to me all the time. It just pulls it right out of the whole system. The heavy metals grab onto the spirulina and they just move it on out. And then a handful of dulse, D-U-L-S-E, dulse. I think that's how you say it. Best one is from Maine. If you want, just message me and I will post all this up there. This is a prescription from Anthony William, the medical medium, which is an incredible book. He's just extraordinarily amazing. Had a huge, massive impact on my life and many people. Anyway, they're just telling me to share that with you right now. So if that at all resonates with you, I would look at it. If you don't know any of his books, I would actually check out his Life-Changing Foods books. Here's the reason why this goes back to surrender. I keep seeing this again and again. A lot of nervous systems that I'm seeing are very agitated due to the levels of high heavy metals in the system that are affecting the viral overload in the body. So viruses, pathogens that are in the body feed off of heavy metals. And so, you know, we're going to have that stuff in our system. But if you're feeling sort of more agitated, more nervous, more anxious, more insecure, it's very powerful to get those into your body and just help flush them out. I have a block underneath my sacrum. I'm just doing a real gentle surrender here. I'm just doing this pulsation because it feels really good through the backs of my legs. In and out. Let's do a hip opener here. Right foot on top of left. And just opening up those hips. Good. Big, long breaths. Good. Other side. The neighbors are at home. They're normally in school, so They are back. Scoop is out. Okay, Charlie, thank you. I'm in the other hip, breathing deeply. Surrender, right? Ooh, surrender. What do you need to let go of? How can you let that go right now? Let a miracle happen. See if you can open up to letting something go forever. Forever, forever, forever. Good. Let's let the soles of the feet come down to the earth. You can lift up the block just one level higher. We're going to come into a supported bridge pose here. And just take your hands here. We're just going to do two of these. Inhale. Exhale towards the heart. Inhale, reach out. Exhale towards the heart. And let's take the palms up to the sky. This is a really great way to encourage surrender, letting go. Palms up towards the sky. The act of releasing and letting go. Let's do two big breaths here. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Let's do one om. Inhale. Beautiful. Moving the blocks, lifting the hips up, and just taking your time as you come down. Let's again rock side to side. Oh, that feels so good to me today, that side to side. Let's do happy baby, taking the feet wide, opening up. Big breath in, big breath out. Let's just rock back and forth on the spine. And then let's completely and entirely let go into Shavasana. I am so honored and tickled that you guys have been on this journey with me for 25 days. This is so great. Thank you. So as you relax completely, as you surrender, the ultimate pose of surrender, let yourself fully, fully release here. And I'll turn to the cards and see what we are meant to be exploring. Oh, wow. This is great. My main teacher guide is coming forward and just going over, wanting me to just sort of look over how we have expanded. Specifically, one, what we're doing is we're really accepting who we are. Yay for us. Yay. Number two, what we're also doing here on this journey, my guides are wanting to commend us for, is that we are really connecting in more with the signs and the communications of non-physical. So, yes. And then the third card here is just, again, a celebration about what we're doing really well. That's what my guides are wanting to focus on, is we're connecting back into our innocence in a beautiful way. So, yeah. Let yourself connect into this feeling of surrender. Let yourself fully let go here. Entirely, completely relax and release. Let's do a big breath and we'll exhale on a sigh. Big breath in. Ah, and letting it go. Good. Let's do another big breath in. Ah, good. Releasing, letting go. Let's begin to wiggle our fingers and our toes. Let's make circles with our hands and with our feet. Reaching up, stretching up, lengthening out. And then rolling on over to your left side and pressing on up to a sit, taking your hands at heart center and really connect into what's occurring for the rest of your day, evening, wherever it might be. How do you integrate more surrender? What does that feel like? What is that experience? See that now. And we're dedicating our own to this experience, excuse me, of greater surrender. Inhale. I'm setting the intention that as we move forward into our day and every moment that we're wanting, we're more in alignment with surrender. Namaste. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for liking and subscribing and passing this word on. So many of you are doing that, and I'm so deeply thankful. It strengthens what we're doing here, which is opening these pathways to bring in more joy, more bliss, more understanding and truth. Have a great day, and we'll see you tomorrow.